What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by AutoTopNL. My name is Max, and today is a great day because we finally got it. The Porsche 718 Cayman GT4 RS, one of the coolest Porsches ever made, if you ask me. It is so angry looking. And I think I speak for every petrolhead if I say that we've been thinking about this for ages, ever since the Cayman was introduced. What would it be like to have like a beast of an engine in the Cayman? Because you have that mid-engine balance, but it always had like a ceiling. The Cayman couldn't ever be as fast as a 911. But now, as sort of a goodbye to the Cayman as we know it, with an internal combustion engine, or at least with solely an internal combustion engine, we know that the next one is going to have some form of electrification, whether that is a full EV or a hybrid, we're not sure yet. But this is a last hurrah for the Cayman as we know it, and it is glorious. Spoiler alert. Today I'm going to show you around it. I'm going to show you the spec we've got it in, because it is very, very nice. That's Martijn in the M3. We actually picked up this car with the M3 in Stuttgart at Porsche. So Porsche asked us if we wanted to go to Stuttgart and pick up this car and drive it back to the Netherlands, and we could film whatever we wanted in the meantime. Well, it is now 4:30 in the afternoon. The rain has come. We have driven over 1,000 kilometers, I think, today to pick up this car. We left at 5 this morning, went to Stuttgart. We left there at 9:30 in the morning, drove all the way back here, and now we've got it at our favorite spot to record our videos. I have to say, I am mega impressed with this car. It is quite loud inside. Of course, it's like a track-oriented car, but it's not bad. I was expecting it to be much, much worse. It's actually quite supple, and the suspension is really good as well. So I already said what we're going to do, so let's start at the front, because as you can see, this car is super aggressive. And part of why this looks so aggressive is because this car has the WEISSACH package. Now, you might know from previous cars like the GT3 RS, GT2 RS, it is a must-have, the WEISSACH package. Everyone wants it. And let's do a quick tour of the car, and I'll show you all the WEISSACH stuff, and then we'll come back to the front. So we've got the exposed carbon front trunk lid. We've got carbon mirrors, carbon intake covers there. We've got a new intake here on the side as well, instead of the side window here, in carbon exposed. That is also WEISSACH. And we've got a carbon spoiler, massive spoiler, exposed carbon, and a titanium exhaust. I think those are the most important ones and the most visible ones. And you get these letters on the rear as well, this Porsche lettering, and a carbon fiber engine cover too. So yeah, it's quite a bit actually. But that is why this car looks so insanely cool. I am freaking fanboying out here, I have to admit. I absolutely love this thing to bits. I think Porsche did an amazing job. They are on a roll. They have been for the last, I don't know, 10 years. Everything they put out is basically gold, apart from the four-cylinder Macan. What? Who said that? Anyway, we've got a very aggressive front bumper with a big splitter down here. This front diffuser basically is also adjustable, and I think that is somewhere in the wheel well, actually. I read that somewhere, but I couldn't find it. But it is adjustable, so you can make it more aggressive for track driving. Same with the rear spoiler, it has two settings. And as I said, this beautiful carbon exposed front trunk lid, is also WEISSACH, but you have to have this, because otherwise it's also carbon fiber, but it's painted in the body color, which is a shame, I think. Body color, GT silver, super nice. And then we've got some winglets here on the side that basically form like air curtains to direct air over the wheels, across the wheels. We've got some air vents here to relieve pressure from the wheel wells. And we've got these NECA ducts, which are inlets for the brakes, for the brake cooling. So I can actually show you guys. If we open this up, you can see that the duct goes here and then into the brakes. But this is super nice. That is very bare as well. That's just
not gloss like this. Very cool, and you can see the duct here. Love that. Porsche badge is just a sticker, as usual with these RSs. Super lightweight, of course. Wheels, we've got these 20-inch forged wheels as standard. There are a few color options available. This is neodyme, which is that super bronzy goldish color that we got from the Boxster anniversary edition, if I'm not mistaken. Very cool color. And we've got carbon ceramic brakes on this car as well, which is optional but a must have because they are magnificent. Center lock wheels, really cool. And then we've got Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2 tires around that. Now you can see that it is super super wet. It's actually drying out already a little bit, but it was way wetter before. And driving a very powerful car with a mid-engine layout on a very wet surface on Cup 2s is like a spider on ice, basically. It is all over the place, and the problem is the tire just lets go. It's not like a Pilot Sport 4S or something like that. You can feel where the grip is, and you know, and you can sort of balance on the limit. And another really cool thing on this car is that you can see the wheel arches here. They are interrupted because they have basically rounded out the rear part of it to extract more air from the wheel well to, again, counter pressure in the wheel wells, and that means less lift. Very nice. GT4 RS on the side as well. Mirror caps, I showed you. More carbon here. This is cooling for the radiators, and this is actually for the air box. So air is taken in here, and you can actually see it in there. I'll show you guys right now. Why not? So you can see the air intake here, and then it goes in there into the engine. And that is basically the party piece of this car, but you will hear more about that later on. That is really cool. Very nice side blades here on the GT4 and the GT4 RS logo. Swan neck mounted spoiler, as with the GT3 992. And for some reason, well, I know for what reason, I like this better on this car, because this is an RS. This is a full-blown like track car, basically. And this fits on this car much better than the GT3, in my opinion. Titanium exhaust, as I said, you can really see it. But I'm wondering, because we had the KN GT with titanium exhaust, and we discovered that it was actually in a Krapovich, but I can't seem to find anything on this one. So, and as I said, that exhaust is part of the WEISSACH package, which is a must-have. Selecting that option, the WEISSACH package, also unlocks the ability to get magnesium wheels on this car, which is very, very cool. It saves another 10 kilos. This car is 35 kilos lighter than a GT4, so we've got lighter glass as well on the rear, for example. So it is 1,415 kilos dry, which is quite a nice weight, I would say, but those magnesium wheels shave off another 10 kilos. But they are very, very expensive. I think they're like 10,000 euros, somewhere around that. I'll show you guys the engine. So we can actually see the top of the airbox here, this carbon bit, and you can see the intakes on the left and on the right with a beautiful blue cage. Oh, it's going to rain again. I have to hurry up. We've got the GT3 992 engine in here, so 4-liter naturally aspirated flat six with, in this case, 500 horsepower and 450 newton meters of torque. Now, the GT3 has 510 horsepower and 470 newton meters, but apparently the exhaust in this car is a bit longer and had to have like a couple of bends. They had to cross the rear axle, which is around here, and some of the suspension parts. And apparently, because the exhaust is a little bit longer than in the GT3, you have a bit more back pressure and you lose 10 horsepower. Now, it's either that or they didn't want to make it as powerful as a 992 GT3. Take your pick. Any guess is as good as mine. It could be both true, basically. But yeah, this is a beast of an engine. It is incredible. And it fits this car so well. Apparently they had to apparently it took them quite some figuring out to get this engine in here, because it sits super low. It's actually like this high. I think the bottom of the engine is like that high. And they had to flip it around 180 degrees. They had to find a space for the gearbox, for the exhaust manifold. Apparently it was quite a challenge, which makes this car even cooler, because they wanted to make the ultimate compromise between road and the track car. And I think they did it. But we are going to drive it on track later this week as well. So stay tuned for that video. Interior wise, we've got a lot of race stacks, which is Porsche's name for Alcantara. We've got a gear lever similar to the one in the GT3. So it looks like a gear shifter, like a manual. And we've got a WEISSACH badge right there. We've got WEISSACH on the seats as well. Beautiful deep sea blue, deep blue sea, whatever color on the seats as well, on the seat belts and on the cage, as I showed you. Yeah, this is a very, very nice interior. Carbon kick plates down here as well. And of course the carbon bucket seats, which are super nice too. Yeah. Okay, so gearbox, PDK from the 991 GT3 RS. Put that in manual, PDK sport, exhaust valves open, traction control off. Where are my brave pills? Where did I leave those? In here? No, okay, we'll have to do without then. Let's take it for a gentle drive in the wet. So it is actually a really good car to drive in the wet, because just hang on, because the power is all the way at the top of the rev range. This engine, as you probably know, revs out to 9000 rpm, but max power is at like 8400 rpm. So you actually don't have that much power low down, which makes it not that tricky to drive in the wet. It's just that the issue is when the tires let go, they just let go. It doesn't matter if that's at 20 kilometers an hour, 50 or 120. I have to say that I'm not sure if these seats will be returned blue. They might be a bit brown, because oh, I did have a couple of moments in like third gear. Oh, that is delicious. Now, this car is actually super smart, because they said like, they said you can't have an exhaust that's too loud anymore. And now you have this crazy induction sound 30 centimeters behind your head. And it is just hair-raising, the sound in here. It is absolutely mental. And you can actually hear the car change. You can hear the valves open in the intake. Okay, so I'll do a launch control with the traction control turned off, so you can see and hear how incredible this car sounds. It is bar none. Okay, so just put in an automatic. I don't have to do anything. Foot on the brake, full throttle. That is insane, right? That is outrageous. How is this possible? I mean, that is crazy. Okay, let's turn on traction control. I'll do another launch control and we'll see if that works. How the traction control copes with this wet surface. So, another one. So it's thinking a lot. It's like, no, 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 too much, too much. And then it sort of gives up. thing is insane. How is this even legal?
So the suspension, we've got adaptive dampers, as you can see right here. The suspension is fully adjustable, manually adjustable. So you can go to the track and adjust your suspension and your aero and whatever you want to change for driving on the track. They also shortened the gear ratios in this car compared to the GT4, which was a real problem in that car, because it just made the car feel slow, and that's not really what you want. Now, I'm going to go on the Autobahn right here. I'm going to turn on the speedo cam as well, but I think it might be a little bit drier a little bit further down the road, so I might switch to that part. We'll see. Traction control on, please. Okay, so I hope you guys can still hear me. Let me just go to seventh gear. So this is like cruising speed, 150 kilometers an hour, and you can, it's actually not bad. And when I hit the throttle a little bit, you can hear, it's like a symphony, the sound changes. That 9,000 RPM in this car is insane. It is so much more intense than a 992 GT3. It's really much more of a hardcore car. Most hardcore cars you can buy right now. It is insane. Porsche said they're not going to limit them, they're just going to limit the time that they're going to build them. But I think, you know, so many people have ordered one. I'm not sure they will build all of them, but we'll see. Just put the dampers in normal mode, which is really nice. That of course is a big difference with the GT3. This car doesn't have the double wishbones all around. It has regular multi-link or independent suspension. It doesn't have the rear wheel steering from the GT3. Okay, so seems like it's a bit drier here. Oh! Oh my god! Oh! I think Andreas Breuninger, the head of the GT department, said that they just wanted to build like the most fun Cayman they could. And you can just feel it in everything. It is so direct but still forgiving, sort of. It doesn't bite your head off unless, you know, you have weather like this, but there we go, full throttle, fourth gear, 9,000 RPM. Oh, those last 500 rounds per minute. Oh, those last 500 RPM are so insane. Is going to explode behind my head. Oh. say. Now, of course, we also measured the 100 to 200. I can't remember the exact number, what it was, something like 7.3 something, which is very, very quick. Oh! But the top speed should be 315 kilometers an hour. Oh my God, that is so loud. Top speed should be 315, but we were able to do 300 GPS, so I'm not sure what happened there. Oh, listen to that. That's it. That is a lot more than I thought was possible after that rain. Holy moly. Oh, man, that is freaking intense. That's one of the most intense cars I've ever driven, I think. Oh, and that PDK is so quick. Oh, this is one crazy ass car. 23 seconds faster around the Nürburgring than a GT4. I mean, how crazy is that? Man, this has been a very, very long day. It's been actually almost 12 hours since I left home to pick up this car in Stuttgart, drive it all the way here, and now I'm going to return it to Porsche. And they are going to take it to the Zandvoort track where we are going to drive it on Thursday. So that is in 2 days. That means I'm going to end this review here. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed driving it. Absolutely mega car. Thanks for watching. If you want to check out the top speed run we did with this car, click this video right here on the right. If you want to check out another review, you can check out this playlist of reviews. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you at the next one. Bye.